This is Vishwanath Chavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now I am here to explain the integer arithmetic. At the end of this session, the students will be able to understand the arithmetic operations on integers. So let us have a glance on how ALU works, then integer representation, then we will see the arithmetic operations on integer. Integer arithmetic. The ALU plays a very important role to perform the arithmetic operations on integer. This arithmetic and logic unit has two inputs, mainly the operand registers through which the operands are fed as the input to perform the operations. And the operations are controlled by the respective control signals. So after performing the operations such as arithmetic and logical operations on given operands, it will generate the result, and result may be stored in registers or memory. So after performing arithmetic operations, the respective flags are going to set or reset. Now let us see how to represent the integer. The first method, which is sign magnitude representation. So in general, for a given n bit sequence of binary number, we can find its magnitude as follows. Let us consider the given number, binary number, is having the positions a0, a1, a2, so on up to a minus n minus 2, and last bit is an minus 1. So for this range, the magnitude of this binary digit is equal to, according to this formula, A is equal to summation of 2 raised to I AI, where I is varying from 0 to n minus 1. So let us consider the example 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this example leads its decimal value, which is equal to 255, according to this formula. So magnitude is 255. This is what sign magnitude representation. So let us expand further. There are several convenience used to represent negative as well as positive integers. So these numbers may be positive or negative. So those can be represented like this. If the sign bit is 0, then it represents positive. If it is 1, it represents negative number. So plus 18 is equal to 0001010. So this leftmost 0 indicates positive. Similarly, the negative number minus 18 can be represented as leftmost bit as 1 and other bit remains as it is. So this is the general case. Through this formula, the magnitude can be found. For positive number, an minus 1 is equal to 0, and this is the magnitude to find the number. Similarly, if number is negative, then a of n minus 1 bit should be 1, and the rightmost bit magnitude can be found with the help of this formula, which is summation of 2 raised to I AI, where I is varying from 0 to n minus 2 in both case, positive and negative. Let us consider the second method, which is 2's complement representation. The 2's method 2's complement method of a given n bit number is defined as its complement plus 1 for the range 2 raised to n. Let us consider a 3 bit number, say 010, so whose 2's complement can be found like this: 1's complement, which is 101 plus 1, which leads 110. So that's like this, represent minus 6 in 2's complement. So this is an example. So first represent plus 6 as 0110. Take the 2's complement, which is 1001. Then add 1 to complement of this number. Then we'll get minus 6, which is equal to 1010. So let us see the characteristics of 2's complement representation. So the number range varies from minus 2 raised to n minus 1 to 2 raised to n minus 1 minus 1 for a given n bit number. So expansion of bit length. Add additional bit position to the left and fill in which the value of the original integer. Regarding overflow rule, if two numbers with the same sign, either it may be positive or negative, are added, then overflow occurs if and only if the result is having opposite sign. Subtraction rule, which is required to find the subtraction of a given two numbers. To subtract B from A, so we need to find the 2's complement of B, then add it to A. So we'll get the subtraction. So these are the three characteristics of 2's complement. Pause this video, think and write the answer for this question. The question is, how to represent single magnitude representation of integer and 2's complement representation of integer. I hope your answer for this question. The answer is like this. Sign magnitude number can be represented. If the sign bit is 0, then it indicates the number is positive. If it is 1, it indicates negative number. And 2's complement can be found like this. Take the 1's complement of given number, then add 1, we'll get it 2's complement. So coming to integer arithmetic, first operation negation. Negation can be found by sign magnitude representation. The rule for forming the negation of a given integer is very simple. Just have an invert of sign bit, we'll get it positive signed binary number, which is equal to say plus 53. So this is plus 53, so sign indicates plus. Negative minus 53, here sign is 1. So 2's complement method, in which as we saw in previous slide, take the complement of given number, then add 1. Negation of integer can be formed by taking Boolean complement of each bit of integer, treating the result as unsigned binary integer. Plus 18, bitwise complement, add 1, you'll get minus 18, which is negation of a given number. Addition and subtraction. So register A is giving the input to adder subtractor, B is second operand. So this is switch. If switch is equal to 0, content of B register is copied, forwarded to adder. If it is 1, it takes complement of B and it will forward to adder. So if switch is equal to 1, then 1's complement plus the switch content 1 will be added, which forms negation of a given number. Then it leads subtraction. So which uses the basic operation XOR. If two inputs are same, result is 0, else 1. So if you XOR a given number with 0, you will get same number. If you XOR the given number with 1, you will get the 1's complement. So this concept is used here to take the complement of a given number. So which helps for subtraction. So this same circuit is going to perform addition as well as subtraction. So next, multiplication, Booth algorithm. So take multiplicand M, multiplier Q, initialize a register A is equal to 0, then insert 0 to Q minus 1 position, initialize the count which is equal to N. So if Q0 and Q1 are 0, 0, then perform A plus M. If Q0 and Q minus 1 are either 1, 1 or 0, 0, then directly go for arithmetic shift right of A, Q and minus 1. Increase the count, decrement the count. So this will keep on repeating. If Q0 and Q minus 1 is equal to 1, 0, go for subtraction. At the end, we'll get, if count is equal to 0, get the result. For division, go for restoring method and non-restoring method. These are the references. Thank you.